News that the consumer watchdog is launching yet another inquiry into petrol prices has done little to impress cynical Sydney drivers.
In fact, Bill, some say all it's done is highlight the apparent lack of power authorities have to tackle the slippery oil companies. Eddie Meyer knows more about this one. Eddie, is anyone getting their hopes up?
Sandra, I actually heard petrol described today as the ultimate grudge purchase. We know we have to buy it, but we grumble every time. And certainly the motorists we spoke to today have no confidence that anything will change with yet another inquiry.
Their prices go up at the same time, down at the same time. Coincidence or collusion? That's the question the competition watchdog wants an answer to. Few, though, are convinced it'll actually get one.
I don't know whether they'll be able to clean it up, but maybe they can try. But I think I don't like their chance as much.
I can't understand it at all. Why do petrol prices go up and down through the week? It's not supply and demand.
Well, there always seems to be an inquiry into petrol prices every 12 to 18 months, and nothing ever comes out of it.
This time the ACCC will focus on the website Informed Sources, which allows petrol stations to share information on price changes. It's concerned petrol retailers are signalling a price intention to their rivals, waiting for a response and then reacting, hurting competition and keeping prices high. Motoring groups say that information should be available to consumers instead, in real time, so they can get the best prices every day.
I don't know any other industry or any other business where three or four competitors share their prices amongst each other every 15 to 30 minutes, but no one else can have that information.
We've been calling for the ACCC to act on fuel prices now for years. They've been toothless in this area.
No company should be above the law. The fear I have is that this inquiry will be so narrowly focused it won't look at the big picture, and the big picture is Coles and Woolworths having so much market power.
Petrol Commissioner Joe DiMarzi, earning $330,000 a year, has already admitted he has no power to regulate or control prices. Nick Xenophon says his position should be axed. Others agree.
Yeah, ridiculous. It's just sack them. They're not doing the job.
Now, the ACCC has actually said more about this current inquiry than it normally would, and it's done that, it says, because this is of such enormous public interest. Even so, the Petrol Commissioner wouldn't talk to us about the finer details of his investigation when we asked today.
Eddie Meyer, thank you.